का जिंदगी बख्श गुलाम, जो छुटकारा देने वाला, जो जिंदगी देने वाला, जो सलामती देने वाला, जो बरकतें देने वाला, जो शिफा देने वाला है, वो आपके लिए लेकर हाजिर हूं। खुदावंद आप सबको बरकत दे।
आर यू रेडी फॉर द वर्ड? आमीन, आमीन। कैन यू टेक साम्स
148
एंड 8th वर्ड,
और उसकी 8वीं आयत, ज़बूर 148, साम 148।
कैन समबडी रीड?
कोई पढ़ सकता है? 8 आयत 148 ज़बूर और उसकी 8 आयत।
It says in English, lightning and hail, snow and fog, stormy wind, fulfilling his words. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Today I am going to preach about the wind in your life.
आज मैं आपके सामने खुदा का कलाम जो है वो बताना चाहता हूँ, जो कि एक हवा जो है हमारी जिंदगी में, आंधी, तूफान जो है हमारी जिंदगी में जो
होता
है। In 2014, 2014 में
I was working in Qatar.
मैं कतर में काम करता था।
I got a call from my sister saying that my mother is sick and she had an attack.
मैंने अपनी बहन की तरफ से मुझे कॉल आई कि मेरी माँ जो है वो बीमार है, उसको अटैक
हुआ। My mom went to England to see my sister.
और मेरी माँ इंग्लैंड गई है मेरी बहन को मिलने के लिए।
She said it's very critical and we are taking to her ICU and all this stuff.
और क्या लिखे? And
next day she said she passed away.
और दूसरे दिन उसने बताया कि वो इस दुनिया से चली गई।
Prior to 1 week before that,
एक हफ्ता उससे पहले,
my boss called me and said,
मेरे बॉस ने मुझे कहा,
your contract is over and there is no job for you.
और कि तुम्हारा कॉन्ट्रैक्ट खत्म हो गया और आपके लिए कोई जॉब नहीं रही।
I went to India, had the funeral and came back. I got a call from the bank saying that your credit card is due, I have to pay immediately. But sometimes in your life, like me, the wind will come one time, another wind will come, another wind will come, it goes on. Oh Lord, I take the authority of the territorial force right now in Jesus' name. I bless the water, the air, and the land of USA right now in Jesus' name. I release the angels right now in Jesus' name. Let the angels go and bring forth the results, what they need, their prayer answers right now in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. In the Bible, when we see, we can see four types of winds there.
बाइबल में खुदा के कलाम में हम चार तरह की हवाओं के बारे में देखते हैं।
कैन समबडी रीड जेनेसिस 41:27 प्लीज?
कोई पैदाइश 41 बाब 41:27 एक पैदाइश 41 बाब और 27 आयत पढ़ देंगे प्लीज।
It speaks about Joseph's dream, correct?
Yes.
Hallelujah. So the east wind always brings judgment on the land.
जो मशरकी या पूर्वी हवा है, वो हमेशा अदालत जो है, अदालत तो ज़ाहिर करती है कि वो ज़मीन पर उस एरिया में अदालत लेता है।
Then we are talking about the west wind.
और फिर जो मगरब से हवा आती है, उसके बारे में।
There we can see in Exodus 10:19.
खरूज 10 बार उसकी 19 आयत।
Somebody can read, please. This wind brings out the demonic forces over our life.
ये जो मगरी हवा है, ये जो जो शैतानी ताकतें जो जो हमारी जिंदगी में आती हैं, उनको उड़ाकर ले जाती हैं।
Amen. Then we are talking about the south wind. Zechariah 9:12-14.
और जो south wind है,
Zechariah. Zechariah 9:12-14. Amen. It talks about, since because of time I'm going ahead, sorry about that. It always brings restoration in our life.
जो जो जुनूबी हवा है वो हमेशा हमारी जिंदगी में जो है वो छुटकारा लेकर आती है.
And the north wind will always blessing to our life.
और शिमाली हवा जो है वो हमारी जिंदगी में बरकतें लेकर आती है.
In our life there are two types of winds.
हमारी जिंदगी में दो तरह की हवाएं आती हैं.
One ordained by God.
एक जो है वो खुदा की तरफ से आती है.
One ordained by the devil, the enemy.
और एक जो है वो शैतान की तरफ से आती है.
Let's look into the Bible, some of the winds. Can we take Genesis 1:2?
आइए कुछ हवाओं के बारे में बाइबल में देखते हैं. पैदाइश Genesis
1:2.
पहला भाग उसकी दूसरी आयत.
And the Spirit of the Lord moved upon the free waters.
पैदाइश का भाग उसकी दूसरी आयत में लिखा है और
जमीन
विराम और सुनसान थी और गहराओं के ऊपर अंधेरा था और खुदा की रूह पानियों की सतह पर जुम्मेश करती थी.
हालेलुया. टुडे गॉड इज सेइंग,
आज खुदा कह रहे हैं,
the Spirit of the Lord is fluttering over this space. Whatever you are going through today, the wind is going to shake it out. The earth was formless before the wind. But when the wind blew, things started changing. Let me tell you, brothers and sisters, if you believe today, your situation is going to be changed. There's a brother praying for a job change. God is saying today, you write down this 17 days from today, you will get a job. A new job. Which you want. And you will come and testify here. My Lord has done good things in my life. Hallelujah. 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 In Exodus 15:21 we can say, God blew a wind and separate the Red Sea. Hallelujah. Today the same God is here. He can split whatever you are going through into two.
आज वो उस समंदर को धोखे से कर देगा जिसमें
साथ. And he will hold your hands like this.
वो आपका हाथ ऐसे
and walk through it, and you will reach the other side, and you will testify the glory of God. How many of you believe it? Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Can somebody read 2 Kings 3:17?
Dusra Salatin.
3:17.
Dusra Salatin, 3 baap aur uski 17 ayat hum padhenge.
Amen. Here God is saying that you have to dig up the holes.
Aap ghar khandak kholo.
No wind.
Koi hawa nahi chalegi.
No rain.
Koi barish nahi hogi.
But it is to be get to be filled by the
mud. Wo sab baaki paani se bhar jayega.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So today, which area you want fulfillment in your life?
Aap kis apni zindagi ke hisse mein chahte hain ki wahan par bharpuri aa jaye.
God is going to fill it without you knowing.
Aap khuda us jagah ko bhar dega, aapko pata nahi chalega.
The moment you step out of this door today,
aap kaise is darwaze se bahar jayenge,
something will happen in your spiritual realm.
Aapki rohani zindagi mein kuch badlav aayega.
That will shift something in your life.
Aapki zindagi mein kuch badal jayega.
And you will again testify the glory of God.
Aur aap khuda ke jalal ki gawah hain.
Pastor.
Yes, Pastor.
I have a Joseph anointing on me.
Khuda Yusuf ki jo masa hai wo bhai keh rahe ke mujh par hai.
Wherever I touch my feet,
jahan bhi main apne paon ka talwa rakhta hu,
it's a multiplication.
Wahan par multiplication, wahan par bahut aap hone shuru ho jayenge.
So souls are going to come.
Ruhi aayegi.
And this church is going to explode with signs and miracles.
Aur ye jo kalisiya hai isme bahut se nishanat aur moje karwayenge.
Pastor, when you pray for somebody within 1 month,
Pastor, aap agar is mahine mein ek kisi ke liye dua karenge,
there will be a miracle.
Ek moja hoga
that will come to the people will know about it.
Aur logon ko iske bare mein pata chalega.
And like Jesus was famous in Galilee and Judah, your name will be famous not only in New York but other states.
Aur jaise Yesu Galilee aur sare Judah mein mashhoor ho gaya tha, tumhara naam bhi jo hai wo sare US mein, New York mein, Brooklyn mein mashhoor ho jayega.
And your church will have other state also, you'll be your same. What is the name of your church, brother?
Metropolitan New Revival.
So that new revival is going to hit some states of America, and you will be traveling to other states for conducting services on Saturdays and Sundays.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Ki branches aur states mein bhi khulegi aur aap Saturday Sunday ki meeting karenge wahan pe daya karenge.
Don't you want your pastor to go outside and preach and win the souls?
Kya aap chahte hain ki pastor aapke baad bhi aaye?
Amen. Hallelujah. 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 Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. What's the time? Okay. We have a time. Okay. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I'm just skipping it. Hallelujah. 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 We can see in Jonah 1:4, God is asking him to go to Nineveh.
यूना की किताब उसका पहला भाग उसकी चर्चा में हम देखते हैं कि खुदा यूना से कह रहा है कि तू नीनवा को जा।
But he went the opposite side.
मगर वो दूसरी तरफ चला गया।
And God sent a big wind.
और खुदा ने एक बड़ी आंधी भेजी है।
And he was thrown in the water.
और फिर उसको पानी में फेंक दिया गया।
You know the story.
आपको पता है सबको यूना की कहानी।
The fish swallowed him.
और उसको जो बड़ी मछली थी उसने उसको निगल लिया।
I think God commanded a fasting to that fish.
और चैलेंज करने का था वो उदाहरण उस मछली को रोजा रखने के लिए मैंने बोला था।
And God stopped his enzymes of digestive enzymes.
और उदाहरण उसके अंदर जो हजम करने वाले जो जो चीजें होती हैं ना उनको रोक दिया था।
And Jonah was sitting here like most of us.
और यूना इसके अंदर बड़े बड़े से ऐसे जैसे बर्बाद जैसे बैठे।
Looking at other fish coming and it is getting plump digestive system is taking action, but he is sitting there. Then he remembered the God. Today God is telling me there are some people sitting here in the fish belly of cancer. About problems about the children. Husband's problem. Wife's problem.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. But today, God is allowing this situation. This is the time to look up and call God. Oh God, my father, have mercy upon us. Have mercy upon my family. Have mercy upon my children. Have mercy upon my job. Have mercy upon my finances. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Today, if you believe, give a clapping to the Lord. Hallelujah. Let the God be glorified. Again, when you see Job 1:9, we can see a wind coming from the desert and destroying everything of Job. I was reading one article about Job. And there one of the scholars of Bible said he lost $790 million worth of gold. Hallelujah. Just imagine you are a multi-millionaire. And just one wind. And you become a zero man. Hallelujah. But like Job, if you are faithful to God and if you believe in God, like Job, you will get all double except your wife. Hallelujah. I was just remembering one joke somebody sent me to WhatsApp. It says like this. You know the coconut? And the helmet, you know, you wear for the bike. You have to always keep it on the head. Same way. You have to keep your wife. Hallelujah. I again remind. Sorry. So another story. The wife told the husband, honey, you should come at 11 o'clock. I have to go for a wedding. So like all of us, like us in husbands, you know, we were proper on time 5 minutes before he came. And he was waiting. 11 o'clock, 11:30, 12:30. She's not coming out. And finally she comes. And asks the husband. Darling, how do I look? We really want to tell the truth always, but we say, honey, you look very fine. And they were going in a bike very fast.
motorcycle पर बैठ के बड़ी तेज
with the light on,
lights on,
and the pastor was standing there and pastor said, hey stop.
Okay, pastor उसने कहा रुक जाओ.
So this man stopped the vehicle for a minute.
और उस आदमी ने अपनी जो मोटरसाइकिल है वो एक मिनट के लिए रोक दी.
And he hugged the pastor.
उसने पास्टर को जप्पी लगाई.
Pastor, danger is sitting behind. Let me go.
Pastor साहब, मेरे पीछे खतरा बैठा है, मुझे जाने दो.
Hallelujah. So let's come back to the New Testament where we can see the wind.
आइए नए अध्याय में एक और हवा के बारे में देखते हैं.
In Mark 4:37.
Marcus 4 bab aur uski 37 ayat.
Can somebody read please?
Marcus 4 bab 37 ayat. तब बड़ी आंधी चली और लहरें कश्ती पर यहां तक आईं कि कश्ती पानी से भरी जा रही.
Hallelujah, we know the story. Jesus is going with the disciple to the other side. But there are a lot of problems. Hallelujah. And he was sleeping like a baby. Hallelujah. Especially for baby Christians who come first time to the church and all. They always say, Roy brother, after coming to the church, I am facing a lot of problems. I always tell them, the enemy will try to test you. Don't fall for it. Because the Jesus is in our boat. Colossians 1 27 or 28 says that Christ in you the hope of glory. Hallelujah. We can see another boat experience for the disciples. In John 6. You know that Jesus was pressing them to go to the other side. Before that incident, Jesus multiplied the bread. So the disciples were very happy. They said, they might have said, Jesus, we will have a private meeting because, you know,
this.
Let others go, we have enough bread, enough fish. But Jesus said, no. You go. And they are going, singing songs hopefully, and suddenly the sea gets off. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let me share my testimony before I go. I was a worldly man, you know, enjoying the life. 94 I came to Dubai. God blessed me with a very good job. Every day 5 o'clock. It was a British company. So we have friends, you know, British people, and they like to drink. So we go to one bar, another bar, because they call it Dutch system. So for example, I'm going with pastor, not for drinking, sorry. I will pay first. Second round pastor will pay. Again next bar I will pay. Next he will pay. So I was having a jolly life. I was the director of human resource for 25,000 employees. It's a very big construction company. And one day our one of the managers leaked our price to the competitor.
और एक दिन क्या हुआ कि किसी और जो एक और मैनेजर था उसने हमारी कीमतें जो थी एक और जो कोई हमारा मुखालिफ था उसको बतानी शुरू कर दी लीक आउट कर दी उस बात.
And because of that we lost 20 contracts.
और उसकी वजह से तकरीबन 20 जो ठेके थे वो हमारे हाथ से निकल गए.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And it was in November 1st.
पहली नवंबर का टाइम था.
So my GM called me, Roy.
मेरे GM ने मुझे बुलाया, Roy.
There's a bad news for you and the company.
और ये बुरी खबर है कंपनी के लिए और आपके लिए भी.
Which one you want to hear first?
आप पहले कौन सी खबर सुनना मांगोगे?
I said anything you please.
भाई ने कहा कि कोई सी भी खबर सुना दे.
See, Roy. Because of this contracts manager leaked the prices, we lost the contracts.
क्योंकि उस ठेकेदार ने जो हमारे साथ है इसने दूसरों को हमारी जो कीमतें थी वो बता दी है इसलिए हमारे कॉन्ट्रैक्ट चले गए.
Out of 25,000 employees, we had to terminate 20,000 employees today with 1 month notice.
आज चीन उस 20,000 नौकर जो लोग हैं उनमें से उनको सबको हमने बारी बारी नोटिस देना कि आपकी जॉब खत्म हो गई.
And regarding managers, out of 32 managers, 30 managers, including you, will be given 2 months notice and your job is over.
और जो 30-35 manager हैं, उनमें से आप भी हो और हमने 2 महीने का नोटिस देंगे और आपकी जॉब खत्म हो जाएगी.
I finished my job because I was doing appraisals and I finished the job and I left the company December 6th.
और मैं जो काम कर रहा था जो कि जो मेरा जिम्मेदारी थी मैं दिसंबर 6 को मैं अपनी काम छोड़कर चला गया.
I was sitting in my house alone.
मैं अपने घर में अकेला बैठा हुआ था.
No phone calls.
कोई फोन कॉल नहीं थी.
No friends.
कोई फ्रेंड दोस्त नहीं थे.
In Dubai those days when you go out and come you can bring 4 bottles from duty free.
आप अगर दुबई उन दिनों में दुबई से बाहर अगर जाते हो फिर वापस आते हो तो ड्यूटी फ्री से 4 बोतलें भी ला सकते हो.
So I used to bring and I counted the bottles how many bottles left.
फिर मैंने गिना कि कितनी बोतलें बाकी रह गईं.
84 बोतल्स.
84 बोतलें थी.
All Shivas Regal, Black Label, all.
सब किस्म की Shivas Regal, Black Label, सब 84 बोतलें.
So I took a decision that I will not drink unless until I get a new job.
और मैंने इरादा किया कि मैं इसके बाद नहीं पीऊंगा जब तक मुझे नई जॉब नहीं मिली.
I don't drink much, but I like entertaining people, so people.
और मैं ज़्यादा तो पीता था, पर मुझे अच्छा लगता था लोगों को मैं ज़्यादा.
And December 14th, 99.
14 दिसंबर 99 में
फर्स्ट टाइम आई क्राइड टू गॉड.
पहली दफा मैं खुदावन के आगे रोया.
आफ्टर अ लॉन्ग टाइम.
दो बड़ी देर तक.
लॉर्ड ही गिव मी अ गुड जॉब.
अगर खुदावन तू मुझे अच्छी जॉब दे.
गुड सैलरी.
अच्छी तनख्वाह हो.
बट आई डिडंट यूज इट.
और मैं तुझे
प्रॉपर्ली. दैट नाइट आई वाज स्लीपिंग.
मैं कभी सो नहीं पाता.
आई वाज स्लीपिंग ऑन द फोर्थ फ्लोर.
मैं चौथी मंजिल पर सो रहा था.
Suddenly the doors and windows started shaking.
अचानक मेरे दरवाजे घर के दरवाजे जो थे और खिड़कियां वो हिलना शुरू हो गई.
I turned.
मैं करवट ली.
I saw Jesus standing there.
मैंने देखा कि खुदावन यीशु मसीह वहां खड़े
हैं. And he called my name in Malayalam, which is my mother tongue.
और उन्होंने मेरी मलयालम जुबान में मुझे बुलाया, मेरा नाम बुलाया.
Roy, this is me, Jesus.
और उन्होंने कहने लगे कि रॉय, ये मैं हूँ खुदावन यीशु मसीह.
I didn't expect that.
मैं ये मुझे मैं नहीं एक्सपेक्ट कर रहा था कि ऐसा.
I thought I was dreaming.
मैंने सोचा मैं ख्वाब देख रहा
हूँ. Slowly I just sat on the edge of the bed.
मैं उठा और आस्ते से उठ के ना अपनी बेड के कोने पर बैठ गया किनारे पर.
Again he said, Roy, this is me, Jesus.
और फिर यीशु ने कहा कि रॉय मैं यीशु हूँ.
Again he said, he was walking nearest to me in an illuminated form. You cannot see his face, but you know, the room was so lit up, like the presence of God was hitting you, electric shock was going through you. Again he said, Roy, this is me, Jesus.
वो बड़ी जलाती हालत में मैं उनको देख नहीं सकता था, मगर सब रोशनी थी, वो मेरी तरफ बढ़ रहे थे और वो उनकी जो मसा था मुझे छू रहा था और बिजली जैसा करंट मेरे अंदर चल रहा. और फिर उन्होंने बोला कि रॉय मैं यीशु हूँ.
I fainted because
मैं वहीं बेहोश हो गया.
I don't know what to do at that time, but now I know what to do.
उस वक्त मुझे नहीं पता था कि मैं अब क्या करना है मुझे, मगर अब मुझे पता है क्या करना है.
Next day he came in my dreams and asked me to read the Bible.
I read the Bible.
I could not understand anything. But the third time I started reading the Bible, it started speaking to me.
I was
so hungry for the Lord.
मैं बहुत ही भूखा पैसा था उसका
पूरा Wherever there's a meeting I used to go, whether it's a Catholic, a Pentecostal or a Protestant church, I used to go and hear.
किसी भी चर्च में कहीं भी कोई मीटिंग होती थी मैं वहां जाता था.
Hallelujah. And in May, April I went for a conference.
और मई में मैं फिर एक कॉन्फ्रेंस के लिए गया.
I was worshiping there.
मैं खुदा की सताइश कर रहा था.
And third day wind came and around me.
और एक हवा आई और उसने मुझे घेर लिया.
I started speaking in tongues.
और मैं गैर जुबानों में बोलने लगा.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
My neighbor asked me whether you can testify this to his house. That's a prayer group.
और मेरे पड़ोसी ने कहा कि क्या आप मेरे घर में जब वो प्रेयर ग्रुप होता है तो वहां पर आकर अपनी गवाही दे सकते हैं.
So I went there to preach for five minutes or 10 minutes.
और मैं वहां गया मैं तब चलो मैं 5 मिनट के लिए और टीचर.
I started preaching, the Holy Ghost hit the people, they started manifesting and also speaking in
tongues. मैंने वहां पर पाखरू के बारे में बताना शुरू किया और वहां पर भी पाखरू जो है वो जुगज करने लगा और लोग गैर जुबान में दुआ करने.
I lost my father 44 years ago. That means I was 17 years old. I lost my father. So my mother was only there. I got one sister. She's a doctor now. They are in UK. After the sermon, I was coming into my house. My mother was standing there. So he said, I want to tell you something. She said, the Lord showed her a vision 20 years back that I am preaching. And she was praying me for 20 years. But let me tell you, the parents, that if you start praying for your children, maybe they are now very bad or very, they are on drugs, they are on alcohol, don't worry. If God can change me, they can be also changed.
Amen.
How many of you believe it? You should every day lay hands on your children and pray for them. Maybe they will not allow if they are older. You lay your hands on the pillow. Lord, when his head or her head touches this pillow, speak to her in visions and dreams. And God will speak. Amen. I have a lot of testimony. I don't have time, but I'll tell you one more. I used to go to South Africa for a conference for Pastor Chris. I don't know how many of you know Pastor Chris. 2016. I went for the conference. So it is a 5-star hotel, and we were in the I was upstairs for a prayer meeting, and I was coming down. I saw all the people lying on the floor.
5-star hotel,
so I have heard of this slaying in spirit, mass slaying in spirit. I also went to see what is happening. Like I thought, like most of the glory of God has come down. When I walked into the lobby, one African man came with a gun and he gave me one tapa on this, and he said, lie down there.
एक अफ्रीकन आया, उसने बंदूक से गन से जहाँ पर मारा और कहा लेट हो।
So I saw the AK-47 first time in my life originally. So I was lying next to a sofa. So I immediately took out my purse and put it underneath. But I didn't have time to take out my wedding ring and the watch, and there he took it. So I thought, God, I came here for your work, your glory. What's happening to me? Hallelujah. Next day the Lord was asking me to go to one of my friend's room for, he said, don't attend the meeting, go and pray with him. So we started praying, and suddenly the glory of God came. And Jesus started walking into me. He said, hold your wedding ring finger like this. And he came and put a ring on my
finger.
Hallelujah. Next day we were praying. And he put a hand on my left shoulder. And he said, this hand will be there wherever you go. So I am transferring that hand to this pastor. Pastor, wherever you go. Wherever you go, this hand will help you when you pray for the sick. Hallelujah, hallelujah. It will operate from today. Hallelujah. You come. Hallelujah. Ratha raba shukala raba ba. Uraba shatiri kala raba ba.
Hallelujah. Thank you.
Let the Holy Spirit back. Let the Holy Spirit fill right up.
Yes, Jesus. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you.
Fill him.
Hallelujah.
I anoint his right hand.
Yes.
For creative miracles.
Yes, Lord. I receive it, Lord.
Healing.
I receive it, Lord.
Deliverance.
I receive it, Lord.
In Jesus' name.
I receive it in Jesus'
name. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Let the sevenfold blessing of Jesus Christ and the Holy Spirit and the Father come right now upon him.
I receive it, Lord. Jesus.
His ministry will be changed from today.
Thank you. I receive it, Lord.
Since my foot touched this pulpit, your church is exploding right now in Jesus' name.
I receive it, Lord Jesus.
Let the anointing move right now.
Yes, I receive.
Let the glory of God fill him.
Yes, I receive.
Fill him right now, right now, right now, right now, right now. In Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah. I will say a few words before I close and start praying. How to handle this kind of winds in your life? Hallelujah. You have to know it. Accept this kind of winds as a part of God's plan. You have to accept it. It's a part of. Second one. Remember the past blessing what God has given you. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Just imagine how gracious he was. When I was in Dubai, I had 4 major accidents. But my God, because of him, I'm standing and preaching in front of you. Seek Lord in the midst of the winds. Lot of prophets might have come and given you a lot of prophetic messages.
नबूवत की कलाम दिए हैं.
Believe that it will be done in Jesus' name.
और आप यकीन करके कलाम यीशु के नाम में आप सब.
Let me tell my testimony. One more small one.
मैं छोटी सी एक और टेस्टिमनी देना चाहता
हूँ. 2005, one of my pastor told me that you will. I'm seeing you American visa on your passport.
मैं एक पाकिस्तान में कहा कि मैं आपके पासपोर्ट पर अमेरिकन वीजा देख रहा हूँ.
Nothing happened.
कुछ हुआ नहीं.
But I took $1 bill of American dollar bill.
और वो कह रहे कि मैं आपको $1 का नोट देता हूँ.
I put it in my purse.
मैंने उसको अपने पर्स में रख लिया.
That dollar is still here.
और वो डॉलर अभी भी इस पर्स में है.
2018 I got 10-year visa.
और 2018 में मुझे अमेरिका का वीजा मिला.
Faith without works will not happen.
और ईमान बगैर अमल के मुर्दा है.
I know that if God told me I'll go to America, I will go to America.
और भगवान ने मुझे कह दिया था कि मैं अमेरिका जाऊंगा तो मैंने मान रख लिया था कि मैं जाऊंगा.
I didn't ask God.
मैंने खुदा से नहीं कहा.
Actually, I was supposed to preach in another church.
आज मैं किसी और चर्च में प्रीच करने वाला था.
That pastor cannot be contacted, so I came here.
और उस पास्टर ने सर कोई कांटेक्ट नहीं किया इसलिए मैं यहां पर आया.
Because I wanted to anoint this pastor.
क्योंकि मैं इस पास्टर को मसा करना चाहता था.
And you will see the miracles and you will call me and testify that Lord is doing mighty things in your church. So whatever God has promised you, claim it. I told Susan and her husband, when I entered this house, God showed me another house. I said they are going to get a new house. I said next time when I come I'll be staying in that house. If they take it seriously. Yes.
Okay.
50-50. No, I was joking. No, they will. So if you start praying, God will touch.
Hey,
this is a 3-hour preaching. I don't want to preach. I want to pray
for you.
Who is having problem with the stomach?
Please
come forward.
Please,
because when I sat in the my stomach was going Come without shy. God wants to touch you. Come. Today is the day the Lord is going to touch you. Hallelujah. Today if you believe. Sister, come. If you believe. God is going to touch you.
Amen.